Listen to the chorus. Why is Taylor Swift representing Croatia in the Eurovision Song Contest? That doesn't make sense, right? Well, in a couple of seconds, I'm going to explain what's exactly happening. First of all, I'm H of the Stage, musician, vocal coach, and the singer-songwriter. And just the other day, I was watching Croatia's contest where they picked the song for the Eurovision, which is called Dora. And this is how it goes. Out of many songs that are submitted, only 14 songs are chosen to compete in this contest. And basically, I watched the whole thing, and there were some songs that were pretty okay. Most of them were kind of boring, if I'm being honest. But there were a couple of artists that stole the show with their performance and their song, and I've actually talked a little bit about this in my Instagram story while watching. So this is what I've said. Bernarda had the most vocally challenging song, and she did great, plus had an amazing performance visually and everything, so I think she could win. And I really thought that Bernarda had everything. She had lows, she had highs, she had a very interesting song, definitely different from everything else. So in my opinion, she had probably the most interesting performance, but this is what I said next. However, it's not always as easy as that. You know, many factors play out, we'll see. Mia Dimsic had a Taylor Swift style song, so that might be more appealing to the masses. And I was pretty darn right about that. My third guest was Toma, who also had a song that sounded, to me, perfect for Eurovision and did more than a solid job. He was really good, you know, maybe not the best, but he really had a solid vocal performance. And, you know, it just had that Eurovision sounding song, you know. Maybe you've heard it more often than not, so maybe it wasn't too interesting, but to me it was just a very nice structured song. It was really a powerful song and I really enjoyed it. This is what I also said. Those are my three picks, although I have to give Bernarda the most points. So Bernarda, in my opinion, was maybe just a bit more interesting, you know, and I thought that she could do very well. But Mia Dimsic, an incredible singer-songwriter from Croatia, won. And I don't have any problem with that. She was my second pick. Beside the ones that I mentioned, Marko Bošnjak was also really amazing. He had a very interesting song. Maybe not visually that interesting like some other performances, but still a very effective song. But let's talk a little bit about Mia and the winning song. The whole time I was watching Eurovision, I was going back and forth with my father commenting about the songs, you know, just chatting. We had a pretty similar opinion about most of them, but the first thing that I've said to him when listening to Mia's performance is that it sounds like a Taylor Swift style song. I've even said Taylor Swift Willow. And then I've actually listened to Willow, and man, it does sound very similar. Now, it has the same BPM, which means the tempo of the track is, you know, the same speed. That's nothing too unusual. But the song structure, the chords, even the melody, it kind of sounds similar. It even has the same kind of vibe. But just how similar it really is, let's put it in a DAW and check out. Mia's song is red, Taylor Swift's song is yellow. So let's compare the beginning. First, let's listen to Mia.
Dreamt of you last night, woke up, you weren't there. 5 nights in a row of dreams I'd never share. You come without a warning, early in the morning. Timing's never been our thing.
Beautiful song.
Leaving me with guilt, the only souvenir you bring.
Okay, before we get into the chorus, let's listen to Taylor's original song, which we are comparing this song to, and let's just hear how similar they are. Very similar, right?
I'm like the water when your ship rolled in that night. Rough on the surface, but you cut through like a knife.
Definitely the same kind of vibe.
And if it was an open shut case, I never would have known from the look on your face. Lost in your current like a priceless wine.
Okay, so now the chorus kicks in. The first thing that I've noticed is that it kind of has the same rhythmic style. So you can't judge a song just by looking at the chords, because in that case, all of the songs are stolen. All of the songs are plagiarized from somewhere. Basically, you can't copyright a song by the chords, because chords are building blocks of the song. That would be the same as if I said that I copyrighted the letter H, and nobody can use the letter H without my consent, without my permission. That just doesn't make sense. So you can't copyright chords. But are these chords even the same? The picking pattern is pretty similar, if not the same, but are the chords the same? So let's listen to Mia's song once again, the beginning. So let's just compare that part to Taylor's part. So, hey, this is Sage from the future editing this video, and I've just noticed something that I wanted to point out. It seems that before I started recording, my sister was playing something on my electric piano, and she actually tuned it down for a whole step. So all of my examples from here on out are actually supposed to be a tone lower. So I was actually playing everything for a whole tone up to be in the right key. So when I say F sharp minor, it's actually E minor, and so on and so forth. All of the ratios, intervals stay the same, but just to point that out. Sorry, it's a stupid mistake, but there you go. It happens. Enjoy the rest of the video. Now here's the first difference. Mia's song is in E minor, while Taylor's song is in F sharp minor. So it's a whole tone apart. Taylor's song is a whole tone higher, and it's not a big of a difference. But one thing that is different is that Taylor's song only has two chords in the beginning, while Mia's song has four. So Taylor's song goes something like this. You know? Or to be more accurate, it goes higher for an octave up. So Taylor's song alternates between F sharp minor and E major, while Mia's song goes something like this. So I'm not really, you know, playing it the same way completely, but Mia's song goes like E minor, G major, A major, then A minor. So four different chords at the beginning of Mia's song, while only two different chords in Taylor's version. What happens when I transpose Mia's song to F sharp minor, the same key of the Taylor Swift song? Do they sound more similar? Well, you be the judge. This is how that sounds. Okay, let's break that a bit apart. So, as I already said, Mia's song has four chords at the beginning, while Taylor's song has only two chords. So, although they have basically the same picking pattern, it's not the same part. So the beginning is a bit different. Let's listen to Mia's song in F sharp minor. This is how it sounds. This is the different part. The first two chords. But that's a different one. Five nights in a row of dreams I'd never share. Okay, now let's listen to Taylor's song. The picking pattern is basically the same. The tempo and everything. But only two chords.
I'm like the water when your ship rolled in that night.
One other thing that's pretty similar is the rhythmic pattern of the singing. So listen to Mia's and Taylor's part at the same time, once again. This is where they differ. But listen. So they both stop. So that's definitely inspired. You can't really make a song like this if you're not really inspired by another song. So far, I wouldn't say that it's plagiarized, but it's definitely so much inspired by Taylor Swift. So I'm pretty sure when they were writing Mia's song, that they had Taylor's song as a reference track, you know, because they really wanted to make a song that kind of feels the same way, that has the similar vibe, but they made it maybe just a little bit too similar. The feeling of the song is kind of the same. The tempo is the same. The picking pattern is pretty much the same, although not all the chords are the same. So, you know, even the singing rhythmic pattern is close, very close at the beginning. So this is what I'll actually do. I'll play the whole song like this. I've actually chopped down Taylor's song because it's a bit longer to the parts that are the most similar to Mia's song. So just to compare them, I'm going to play them at the same time. Sometimes I'm going to solo Mia's song, sometimes I'm going to solo Taylor's song. So just so you can get an idea how similar they actually sound. So let's go. This is going to be interesting. Here's both of them at the same time. Dreamt of you last night, woke up in my night. listen to Taylor's.
Rough on the surface, but you cut through like a knife.
And Mia's, listen to this part.
You come without a warning, early in the morning. Timing's never been our
thing. Now Taylor's.
Face lost in your current like a priceless wine.
That part is a bit different, but listen to the chorus.
I wanted to say, yes, I know. He's the potion you were guilty of pleasure.
So you know, again, pretty similar, but let's continue listening. What else is happening here when they both play at the same time?
One love is enough, that's all you ever get. At least that's what they tell you. So I can't forget.
The beginning, the first two chords are pretty darn close. Listen to the chorus. This is actually pretty close. The chorus is the closest part. So the chorus is definitely the closest part of the song. I would say that it has all the same chords. The melody and the rhythmic pattern is pretty similar. Even the descending line that Mia does and the staccato notes, which means very short singing. It's pretty close to Taylor's version. Now let's listen to the ending, the last part. Again, the chorus. This part sounds the most similar to me. Actually, could make a great remix out of this. And listen to the ending. Man, the ending is even, you know, it's definitely inspired. Definitely, this song is no doubt inspired by Taylor Swift. Not just any Taylor Swift song, but exactly this song, which is called Willow. So once again, let's just listen to the ending. Even at the ending, Mia does kind of the same thing that Taylor does with this ah kind of thing. You can say like that's nothing too original, but it's kind of weird if you have the song that sounds pretty much the same, it kind of ends in a kind of same manner. So it's really close. You know, so this is what I think about this whole situation. It's very interesting. Is the song plagiarized? I wouldn't go as far to say that the song is plagiarized because, you know, as I already said, you can't own a chord. That's not something that you can copyright. Basically, you have millions of songs that use the same four chords. And if you were to copyright one song, that means nobody could write a song like that. It's too complicated to explain in just one video. But as I already said, I can't own a letter. You can't own a letter A, a letter H, and forbid somebody to use those letters in words. Because you can't own something that creates, that's a building block for something, basically. You can't copyright chords. You can't even copyright basically rhythm. One thing that you definitely can protect with copyright is the melody. But there's only so many melodies that will go well with these chords. Now, the singing melody is definitely different. There's no doubt about that. And that's a good thing for Mia. But the whole song, the whole feel of the song, as I said, you can't copyright single parts like chords or rhythm individually. But when you have a finished product, the song, you can copyright all of it together. Basically, this song has the same tempo. It has the same feel. It has the same picking pattern, which is still, you know, nothing too strange. But the singing melody, this is the part that is really tricky. It's pretty similar to Taylor's singing when it comes to the rhythmics. So Yes, Mia is not singing the same notes. She's not singing the same melody, but she is singing in basically the same way that Taylor is. Although Mia is not singing the same melody as Taylor, it's definitely an interpretation of what Taylor is singing. So when Taylor is singing staccatos, Mia is also singing staccatos. She's singing shorter notes. When Taylor is singing legato notes and kind of this... And that part especially is always kind of played around in Mia's song as well. Not to the same degree. It's not definitely ever the same, but it's the same theme. When we take everything into consideration, this song maybe doesn't plagiarize Taylor Swift, but man, it's really getting close there. So it's pretty similar. As I said, the feel, the tempo, even the instruments chosen, the feel of the song, it's really mellow. It's really kind of, well, sad and happy at the same time. You know, it's kind of dark. Another thing that makes this whole thing interesting is that Mia is basically inspired a lot by country music. And Taylor Swift started as a country artist. She evolved later into a more pop kind of star, but she definitely started as a country artist. And even now when I'm listening to Taylor Swift songs, I always think about how she started writing them on the guitar. And she always starts in that kind of country manner, and then she kind of tries to transform them into a more pop song. That's not always the case, but often I hear that. So Mia and Taylor Swift have that kind of a similarity. They both play the guitar, and they both play in this storytelling kind of manner. So I wouldn't categorize any of them as this kind of belty diva kind of singer, because they're not that. They're more intimate. Their lyrics are basically the most important thing of the song. And I'm really fond of Mia's work. I really enjoy her as an artist. I think she's brilliant. And I also love Taylor Swift songs. So there's no doubt in my mind that they had this Taylor Swift song as a reference track while making their track for Dora or for Eurovision. Another thing that I'm pretty sure is happening here, although I have no way to prove it, is that they probably made this song just similar enough so people will talk about it. I can't wait for this year's Eurovision just because of this song. I'm sure that there will be more channels comparing these songs, and I'm sure that the news articles are going to be all over the place comparing Taylor and Mia. And I'm pretty sure that they've actually done all of this intentionally, because it's kind of a great marketing tool. Everybody's going to talk about it. Who knows, maybe even Taylor Swift hears this song for herself and maybe she can tell us more. One thing that's pretty sure, Mia is an incredible artist, a great storyteller, and I can't wait to see how she's going to do in Eurovision. I hope that because of these similarities, Taylor Swift fans will actually vote for her and maybe even, you know, help her win the Eurovision contest. Who knows? That's just me predicting stuff, but it's going to be awesome if I turn out to be correct. I wish Mia all the luck, and I hope that the world recognizes her as a new star. And thank you all for watching, and let me know what you think about the song. Is it similar? Is it too similar? Is it plagiarized? And all that cool stuff. Remember to like, share this video around everywhere, because it really helps me grow the channel more than you might realize. And subscribe to the channel if you enjoy videos like this. If you want to see these videos before anybody else, consider becoming part of my Patreon page, because that's where everything is happening. And what can I say? You look wonderful, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.